Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Happy you're all here tonight. And how are we doing on our midterms? We're doing well, I know. I have no doubt whatsoever. I'm glad you're here, despite them, or maybe even because of them. I don't know. The Barber First Essay for Orchestra premiered in 1938, the same evening that the Adagio for Strings premiered. So when you're a young composer like Samuel Barber would have been, that's a heck of a 1-2 punch to have on the same night. Just a marvelous piece of concision, excitement, clarity in orchestration, and clarity of form. Sounds a lot like classical music to me, and I mean that with the classical era, Haydn, Mozart, Cimarosa, people like that, which is part of the reason why we programmed it before the Mozart to come, just to connect the 20th century back to the 18th century. And we're playing a work that Mitsuo hasn't done for quite a while, the D major flute concerto of Mozart. The G major seems to have a little more currency right now. It's much more in vogue than the D, but the D is such a delightful piece, and when our soloist agreed to it, I couldn't have been happier. And what a wonderful circumstance that not only is our soloist the assistant principal flute of the Houston Symphony, but also an MIT grad, class of 07, course 4. And for those of you that are out there at home or in the audience that still don't know what in the world I mean by course 4, that is architecture. I'm still learning them myself. It's a great pleasure to welcome home this evening Matthew Reutstein.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. So yesterday, of course, was Pi Day here at MIT, which is cause for massive celebration. So we partied hardy, and today is the Ides of March. Beware. So far, so good, with the exception of that a flower delivery didn't get made. So Matthew Reutstein, if you're still out here, there he is. Matthew, come on down. I barely needed any excuse for him to have another bow. So fantastic. So my wonderful colleague who's about to come on stage, David DeVoe, magnificent pianist, has been a member of our faculty for a long time, taught many different courses, individual piano lessons. He's got an amazing piano studio here. We've had many winners in the concerto competition be students from his studio. But he's also an avid fan of Wagner. So hence the Wagner opening, apart from his love of that composer and that composer's work, there's a sense of the grandiose, even in that short-ish overture, that stems from Wagner's love of the grandiose that was in Beethoven for Wagner. Beethoven was the ultimate conception of what a composer should be, particularly the bigger pieces, the Eroica Symphony, Fidelio, the Ninth Symphony, the Missa Solemnis, and he draws upon that. You may have heard moments of dense counterpoint a la Bach channeled through Beethoven. So I thought, what a better piece to open the second act with. And without any further ado, the wonderful fifth piano concerto, the subtitled The Emperor of Beethoven in E-flat, and David DeVoe.
Thank you. Thank you.